In this video, I'll talk about securing new business for residential clients. And while I do that, I'm going to set up a typical site we would have been asked to explore, often in connection with new zoning or new regulations having been announced, and perhaps not even ratified. My name is Jesper, and I'm an architect at Autodesk. Before transitioning into tech from my partner in my architecture studio, this was my bread and butter workflow for securing new business for our studio. It starts with setting up your site and getting context. I'm pulling up an address, which spawns a georeferenced terrain with contextual data for me in Forma. Data sources vary from market to market, depending on available databases. And you could always sort of buy high fidelity data from commercial data providers, but you've got no money to spend, so free it is. But a lot of our business came from first touch developers. By that, I mean in our market, it is not uncommon for landowners to sell to a first touch developer. This developer usually enriches the value of a site by collating several different adjacent properties into one development property, and then building a business case for this development. Entirely dependent on the economy or circumstances. It might either be developed by the first touch developer, or it might be sold to someone with deeper pockets and sort of a longer financial perspective. Anyway, let's study up on some regulation documentation and get some zoning into Forma. Again, I'm just pulling from publicly available zoning maps and in the interest of speed, screenshotting them and putting them into Forma. This is at this point just a quick and dirty job, and we can always get better, more vectorized, probably payable data later on. At this point, you've got no job, no money, and no contract. So you're spinning out projects for free or for cheap in the hope of landing future business. And if you've done this part of the job, you know that the turnover is high, the deadlines are short, the expectations are even higher, and your job in essence is to quickly prove that you either have a business case or not for your client, and then to de-risk that business case as much as possible. And we're talking about doing this in days, not weeks, definitely not months. I love that in this part of the job, but I'd love it even more if I had something like Forma back then. We are drawing inside the lines, meaning we're filling the site according to regulation, making this our base case. What we can put in here without challenging the regulation that exists, and then depending on the disposition of our client, we may work with them to propose something that challenges the zoning, challenge some heights, or propose an alternative plan for the site. This is a high risk, high reward situation. So for now, we're going to put up our boundaries and constraints and make sure we respect those. With those in place, we're going to start massing. And we're going to be massing with something that makes sense to us to use as a template. At our studio, we'd favor apartments with single core access and as many dual aspect apartments as possible. And I know this doesn't make sense in a market where this building code doesn't allow for this kind of typology, but I'm telling a local story. All architecture is local. And I hope you can apply it to your market, tailored to sort of your specific conditions. This is your moat, your architecture. And did you know that anyone in your hub can set up a preset of standardized plans that you can use in these massing studies to get unit estimations for floor plans? So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to set up a dummy building over here on the side just to demonstrate. We're going to place massing that has a section every 20 meters or so. I'm going to make them 12 meters deep. This is the floor plan sketch tool, and I'm just going to do a basic apartment typology that I'd like to apply as a template before getting into the nitty gritty. I'm going to do a three-door mix with one single aspect and two dual aspect apartments, and a sort of generous vertical transportation core with elevators and stairs. Try to keep on the facade to allow for some natural light, a little luxury for our stair users. Where, you know, using stairs is great for health and sustainability when possible. This can be done ahead of time in any project and shared across your studio's Forma hub. And while at this, I'm going to use my rule of thumb when it comes to sizes as well and designate 0 to 35 square meters as studios, 35 to 45 as one bedrooms, 45 to 70 or 75 as two bedrooms, and then 75 and up to be three or four bedrooms, depending on sort of what we decide on. Let's see, we're going to fill all our zoning constraints with massing. And we end up at this point with sort of a gross floor area or a BTA, because this is a localized market, it stands for brutto total area. same as the gross floor area. I could also set up my own parameters here if I'd like. And this is where we're at after about 20 minutes of work in Forma. What we really want to do is to avoid having to do double work or do over detailing that don't translate downstream at this point. So that's why we're kind of still playing with these like sugar cubes in space, little boxes on the hillside. It's a start to massing. It's an understanding of how much GFA your site can carry, which we would refer to as our total utilization rate. Or in the US, you'd probably something like see an FAR. All right, let's deploy some typology strategies. Remember the templates we built before? Let's apply that to all the massing we have in our current design. Once you've done that, you can break down your massing into unit distributions, and you can follow that in the UI as you design. This gives you a specific target of one bedroom apartments, two bedroom apartments, and so on. Now, typically for our market, you'd see some sort of regulation that requires what we call a high-low typology mix. So mixing apartments with larger family-oriented units, such as either larger apartments, or in this case, I'm going to experiment with some row houses instead of this massing. And I'm not sure where to put it. So I can either put it in the west, in the interior of my site, to the east along the road, or to the south. In order to make up my mind about this, I'm going to quickly look at the sun condition and outdoor area condition of this site. We are going to be looking at these two side by side. And based on what I'm seeing, I'd like to put the row houses in the interior, I think, or possibly the east, but I think I'm keeping the subsection, which is leading to subway. Looking at the comparison, I'm leaning towards keeping the row houses to the west for two reasons. They're taller in the terrain, so it's more harmonious with the apartment buildings next to it. But it also intuitively, I find it easier to deal with noise on facades and outdoor areas on apartments compared to small. Let's recap. I've done two alternative design proposals. Both have roughly the same amount of gross floor area. I have an understanding of the unit mix that could be based on my template. Nowhere near locked down, but it's just enough for me and my developer, my client, to start playing with the pro forma of a project. I've made sure I'm within my zoning constraints, and I've solved a noise situation that could have impacted us downstream. And that's all in an hour's worth of work. I've done a basic feasibility study, I've de-risked my project, and I am now ready to bring this into a conversation first with my team and my principal architecture, and then with our developers in hopes of landing the job. Or, second best case, if this project doesn't make sense financially for our developer, they know now they can work with us to build business cases when they're considering buying a site. Hope that helps. See you next time.